I am Kesrstin Barup. I am an architect and a professor of architectural conservation, and I work with heritage buildings, a lot of churches, but also other buildings. Well, you know, I think that the religious heritage is really important because, I mean, we stand here now, and that is exactly between the past and the future. And it is the most extensive heritage we have, maybe, at least in Sweden. And therefore, it's also kind of an anchor in society to work on, and it's a possibility to explain change, and it can be used for so many different things. Well, you know, I was born in a small village in the south of Sweden, in a house with a garden, and also, you know, our neighbors had houses with gardens, and God had the biggest and most beautiful, magnificent house. It was big and whitewashed, and the atmosphere in the room with the walls and the huge volume and the acoustics, it was so impressive, and I liked it a lot. Yeah, well, you know, then I have had the possibility to, and the privilege, I must say, to work with lots of churches, and both as a professor of architectural conservation. I have worked with students of architecture together with students of theology, and that has been a learning process for me as well as the students. And concerning the architects' conservation work with churches, it involves so many people, people who know theology, but also people who know lots of other things, and craftsmen, artists, engineers, a lot of different people, and it's kind of a teamwork, and it's a process that involves a great part of society, and that is also kind of a learning process for us all. And two projects are never alike, and that is one of the things I like with this work. And I also think that we have so many churches, and in Sweden right now they are going through a great change that can be an opportunity, but of course can also be, I would say, risks, because as it is, well, it is, as I said, foothold of our civilization in a way. It demands quality and beauty, and it can take a lot of change, but that means we have to remember this with quality and beauty, and that doesn't necessarily have to do with money. We have to take care of what we have, the embedded qualities, because then we can improve them, and we can make them sustainable and also make them maintainable. And I think those two words are maybe the main things to sustain and maintain this heritage for future generations, because it is a bit more complicated than when I lived in our little village, and then we need this legacy from the past to change and to use, and also to, in this sustainable and maintainable way, bring to the future.